Hi, church family. I'm going to be talking about focusing on prayer for guidance and for vision. Psalm 32:8 says, "I will instruct you and teach you in the way that you should go. I will counsel you with my eye upon you." What a promise that is from the Lord, that He will give us guidance in our lives and show us the way that we're to go. And His word is just full of story after story of how He has done that for His people throughout the generations. His guidance is not just vague, one-size-fits-all type of guidance, but He comes to meet with us as individuals because He is the one who knit us together and knows us best. When we turn to the Lord for guidance, we're acknowledging that we need to be led. We're acknowledging that we don't have all the answers, that we need help beyond ourselves, and God is willing and He's so able to help us. He has said that He is our Father, that He is the shepherd of the sheep, that He is the Lord of hosts, that He is the King of glory. All of these connotate a sense of authority and the ability to lead, and how much we can trust Him to lead us because He is one who knows all things and we can completely entrust our lives to Him. When He instructs us in the way that we should go, it really is the way that we should go. The Word says that man thinks that there's a way that seems right unto him, but that it isn't right at all. But God's guidance to us is always right. And what an assurance that is. Interestingly, even Jesus asked for guidance. What an example He was to us. He said, "I don't do anything apart from the Father. I seek direction from Him and I do what He tells me to do." And so very often we think, well, we know what to do. We know the scripture. But if the one who is the Word is asking for direction from His Father, how much more should we turn towards the Father and ask Him for direction? When we do that, we get a sense of real mission and purpose and for our lives. Jesus never lost sight of why He had come to the earth. He did so many things and people clamored for His attention, but He never lost sight of His purpose, and that was to go to the cross. And I believe that purpose was fostered in His time of prayer as He spent time before the Father. And how much we need to spend time with the Father to understand that He has a plan and a purpose for our life at every stage of our life. I know myself, I'm in the stage where I'm now in retirement, and it's a new stage of life. And I think, okay, God, what do You have in mind? But God has something in mind, that we never outgrow the need to be led by Him, or a sense that He's done using us, that we belong to Him and we belong to His kingdom, and He has kingdom purposes in mind for us. And so may we come to Him every day asking for His guidance and His direction. In closing, Psalm 25:4 says, "Show me Your ways, O Lord, teach me Your paths. Guide me in Your truth and teach me, for You are God my Savior, and my hope is in You all day long." Show me Your ways, O Lord. Guide me. And that is our prayer, that the Lord will show us His ways and that He will lead us in the way that He would have us to go. God bless you all.